तो अभी तक के वीडियोस में हम लोगों ने देखा व्हाट इज फिजिकल मेजरमेंट, व्हाट आर द साइकिल ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंटल साइंस, व्हाट इज मेजरमेंट, व्हाट इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ मेजरमेंट, व्हाट इज वैल्यू, यूनिट, अनसर्टेनिटी, व्हाट इज सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर, व्हाट आर द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग द सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स, एंड देन व्हाट आर द सोर्सेस ऑफ अनसर्टेनिटी एंड द एक्सपेरिमेंटल एरर. There are some errors in which we have systematic errors. Now, in this video, we are going to learn about the different types of errors, that is, random error. So, what is random error? Inherent variation in a measured parameter are directly assessed by making repeated measurements to examine the distribution of values obtained. Certain practices are commonly used to estimate the uncertainty expected in the single measurement. That means, एक single measurement करने के समय किसी भी value को find करने के लिए जब हम लोग किसी के value को हम लोग repeated value find करते हैं और repeat मतलब बार बार value find करने के बाद भी value same ही एस्टिमेटेड वैल्यू नहीं आए उस तरह के एरर को हम लोग रैंडम एरर कहते हैं. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज रीडिंग एरर एंड कैलिब्रेशन एक्यूरेशन. सो व्हाट इज रीडिंग एरर ऑफ स्केल? व्हेन अ पॉइंटर रीड्स अगेंस्ट ए स्केल द अनसर्टेनिटी इज कोटेड एज प्लस माइनस सम फ्रैक्शन ऑफ द स्मॉलेस्ट स्केल डिविजन. द क्राइटेरिया यूज्ड शुड बी स्टेटेड. That means reading that means क्या हुआ कि स्केल जो है हमारा जिस रीडिंग पे होना चाहिए वहां पे ना होकर या तो लेफ्ट साइड में या तो राइट साइड में वो एरर को शो करता हो. इस तरह के एरर्स को हम लोग कहते हैं रीडिंग एरर ऑफ ए स्केल. इस तरह के एरर्स को हम लोग वर्नियर कैलिपर एंड स्क्रू गॉज में क्लास 11th में देख चुके हैं जहां पे मेन स्केल रीडिंग एंड सर्कुलर स्केल रीडिंग और वर्नियर स्केल रीडिंग जो है वो मैच नहीं करते. सो ये वैल्यू या तो प्लस या तो माइनस में होते हैं जिसे एरर को हम लोग ऐड करते हैं या फिर सब्ट्रैक्ट करते हैं. नेक्स्ट एरर इज मैकेनिकल लिंकेज. सम टाइप इन द मैकेनिकल एपरेटस दैट इज गियर एंड मैकेनिकल कनेक्शन बिटवीन ए नोब एंड द सिस्टम इज मूव्ड इनवेरिएबली इन्वॉल्व सम लूजनेस एंड backless. This means that the system may not be in the exactly the same position when a reading is approached from one junction direction that is high as in the other low. The uncertainty due to the backless should always be checked by experiment. It is good practice to always approach a reading from same direction as long as all calibration are carried out using the same procedure. Next is thermal and mechanical drift. Slow thermal and mechanical changes may create unidirectional shift in a measured value. Careful experimental design is required to minimize the such drift. When appropriate and quoted uncertainty must include the possibility of the drift. So this type of error arises due to the thermal or mechanical drift. Next is instrumentation. The accuracy of measurement is stated in the specification for the instrument either as plus minus defined value or plus minus percentage full scale. This is often scale dependent. In general, there is a correction between the GOR granted accuracy of the instrument and its cost. Next is reading error versus statistical analysis. The uncertainty estimated in a single reading by the above method should be consistent with the distribution values obtained by the repeated measurement. If there is a substantial difference, the origin of the difference should be examined. That means अगर दोनों के बीच में काफी ज्यादा difference है तो हम लोग को difference का जो कारण है उसको फाइंड करना होगा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एक एग्जाम्पल हम लोग ले The reading error of a scale reflects the best precision that can be achieved. If the range highest to lowest of the repeated measurement is larger than plus minus, that is reading error, it is probable that backlash or some complexity in the measurement exists. For example, there is a reading of DC voltage and its accuracy. So let's the reading is range is 200 millivolt, 2 volt, 20 volt, 200 volt, 1000 volt, and the resolution is 1 microvolt, 10 microvolt, 100 microvolt, 1 millivolt and 10 millivolt. So on temperature, if it is occurs, this reading is occurred for 24 hours in between the temperature 22 to 24 degrees Celsius. The approximate accuracy is 0.007 plus 2. Next is second, for 2 volt this value is 0.005 plus 2, for 20 volt it is 0.006 plus 2, and for 200 volt it is 0.006 plus 2, and for 1000 volt it is 0.007 plus 2. Similarly, if the experiment is occurs for 1 year, then for 18 to 28 degrees Celsius, the value of for the range 200 millivolt is 0.016 plus 3, and so on the process begin. इस तरह से हम लोग का reading हमारा आगे तक लेके जा रहे हैं. So the range of the value observed allows the precision of the measurement and primary origin of error to be assessed. मतलब इसमें error क्या है उसको हम लोग find कर सकते हैं. If the range is consistent with or greater than the reading error, the mean and the analysis of the range defines the precision of the result. The reading error is then ignored. मतलब इससे सारे values के हम लोग mean value find करके, average value find करके errors को हम लोग find कर सकते हैं. The calibration accuracy of a meter and of an instrument should always be recorded so that the probability of systematic error is known. Whether the uncertainty arises from calibration is included in the final quoted uncertainty depends on the experimental precision of the measurement. If the experimental precision is comparable with the calibration, the accuracy both factors must be considered. If the range of the observation for the exceeds the calibration accuracy, the latter is ignored. The next is uncertainty. The progression in the uncertainty from that is signal measurement to that of system. So it is the block diagram of uncertainty. The instrument uncertainty plus systematic errors. Next is repeatability of the single measurement. कितनी बार हम इसको repeat कर रहे हैं? Then repeat of the experiment, and this value continues for the quoted uncertainty. कितने values के लिए हम इसको uncertainty कर रहे हैं? तो ये single measurement के लिए single से denote किया गया है यहाँ पे. Repeated मान लेते हैं इसको 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times इसको repeat कर रहे हैं, तो repeated measurement के लिए है ये. And then फिर ये repeated measurement और भी अगर ये repeat हो रहा है तो इसके लिए फिर हमारा और भी value repeat हो रहा है. इस तरह से ये process होते रहेगा. So let for example है हम लोग यहाँ पे. Let the resistivity rho of a material is determined by the measurement of R plus minus delta R. Resistance हम लोग find कर रहे हैं. Ohm of a sample of the length. Length हमारा है sample जिसका है L plus minus delta L. Delta L that means यहाँ पे हमारा जो है value जो है find कर रहे हैं हम लोग. उसका measurement में ये error है. And the area is A plus minus delta A m square, followed by the calculation of, अगर rho में हमारा फिर calculation करेंगे तो rho में भी जो error होगा वो हमारा rho plus minus delta rho from R A divided by L. वो जानते हैं rho is equal to होता है R A divided by L. So estimated uncertainty plus minus delta is be the single measurement. Using the same or the similar sample, one might repeat the measurement with the different applied voltages, which may affect heating of the sample or reduced length, which may change the effect of the electrodes. Averaging the results given from rho sample plus minus delta rho sample for the type of the sample. New sample from the fresh batches of material may now be prepared and measured to check the reproducibility of the material. Averaging the result gives rho material plus minus rho material. This is the true result for the resistivity of the material. The next is the analysis of repeated measurement. हम लोग repeated measurement को कैसे analyze करेंगे? क्या-क्या procedure है? The repeated measurement of a quantity are invariably distributed about a mean or average value. This may be due to number one, experimental difficulties is repeating a measurement, that is roughness of the end of a bar, differences in contact resistance or reading error. Number two, the variation in the medium in which an experiment is performed, that is tinkling of starlight as it passes through Earth's upper atmosphere. Number three, inherent fluctuation in a quantity, that is collection of charge at an electrode, detection of radioactive decay products from a nucleus. The results are evaluated by taking a set of n values of a quantity x, calculating the average value x bar by considering how the values are distributed about x bar. Such a set of n values is x1, x2, x3 up to xi, ith value, up to xn for n number of values. So the average value will be x bar is equal to 1 by n summation x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus xi plus xn. Summation ke form mein isko likhenge, I is equal to 1 to n xn. The summation refers to the sum of the n readings and I goes from 1 to n. The distribution of sample of n readings about the mean value can be assessed in several ways. Next is mean deviation. The mean deviation is d is equal to 1 by n summation xi minus x bar. मतलब कि particular कोई भी value जो है वो mean value से, जो mean value हम लोगों ने ऊपर में calculate किया उस mean value से उसका कितना difference है. So that is called mean deviation. So where the mod of xi minus x bar is absolute value of the deviation of each reading from average x. Next is variance. Variance is denoted by s square is equal to 1 by n minus 1 summation xi minus x bar whole square. This is the sample variance of a finite number of n readings. The denominator n minus 1 is used to account for the fact that one piece of information is used to estimate the mean value x bar. If n tends to infinity, n minus 1 is nearly equal to n, and the standard deviation sigma is equal to root over s square is obtained. The variance and the standard deviation reflect the distribution of values about the mean. Distribution function. The distribution of reading about x bar, that is average value, can be assessed by constricting the number of readings which occurs in a particular interval defined by x and x plus delta x. The size of the bin or the interval delta x is arbitrary and is chosen for convenience. Such a plot is shown in the figure A. So in this figure, the value of x increases from 0 to x to the power n. So this is the first value, x1. Then second value is x plus x. Then third value will be x plus x plus x. So ith value is xi. And this is the mean value, which is denoted by x bar. This is called parent distribution, and this is the width of the distribution. So this is frequency distribution for a set of data. Now in the second figure, there is figure 2 and there is figure 3, figure B or figure C. So figure B and figure C represent the non-symmetrical distribution due to the experimental artifacts. So figure A is a plot of number of readings which falls in the particular interval x2 x plus delta x versus the value of x. there are total number of n readings in the distribution, ith bin is defined as xi. For a finite number of reading, this graph is histogram of boxes shown as dotted, called the sample distribution. Now in the figure B and figure C shows two types of anomalous distribution which may arise due to from the experiment. For example, there may be a localized bump on the end of the bar. So this is the asymmetrical distribution of the experimental data. Now next is parent distribution. What is parent distribution? If the number of readings is very large, that is n is tends to infinity, the width of the boxes can be made very small while still retaining a reasonable number of points in each box. मतलब हमारा जो width of the box होगा वो काफी कम हो जाएगा, लेकिन तब भी हम लोग उसमें एक simply एक points को हम लोग जरूर measure कर सकते हैं किसी भी box में. The histogram then approaches a smooth line known as Parent's distribution. The line gives the probability p x n, x for the quantity and n for number of value. That number of values in the range xi to xi plus delta x is n times xi. The mean of the parent distribution is denoted by mu, while the variance is denoted by sigma square. The parameter sigma is known as standard deviation for a finite number of measurement. The values in the boxes at any xi of the sample histogram are scattered about the line defining the parent distribution. A convenient technique for calculating the standard deviation is obtained by expanding the expression for variance with n tends to infinity. So sigma square is equal to 1 by n summation x minus mu square. So if we expand it to a minus b ka whole square, that is x square minus 2 mu x plus mu square. Let sigma x is equal to mu into x, so it is mu square n square, so our value yahan par reduce ho jayega, x square minus mu square. The standard deviation sigma is square root of average of the square minus the square of the average. Isi ko word form mein yahan pe likha gaya. The distribution function of px is the probability of value occurring at the particular value between x and x plus px. And px implies the n out of n values occurs at x. The overall distribution must contain all n values of x. That is, thus summation nx is equal to capital N and px delta x is equal to n. A measure distribution function has no defined as Peary shape and mainly represent the experimental data. So next video mein hum log कुछ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन फंक्शंस के बारे में पढ़ेंगे, बाइनोमियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशंस उसके प्रॉपर्टीज के बारे में पढ़ेंगे जो हमारे फर्स्ट चैप्टर का एक्सपेरिमेंटल फिजिक्स का फर्स्ट चैप्टर का लास्ट टॉपिक होगा. उस टॉपिक के बाद हम लोग नेक्स्ट टॉपिक सिस्टम्स के बारे में आगे पढ़ेंगे.